stillness in the atmosphere. Oh, come lay down the burden you have carried, for in the sanctuary God is real. He is here.
Oh yes, He is here.
If you may please, you can turn with me in your Bibles to St. Mark chapter 16. And when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James and Salome had brought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. And they said among themselves, who will roll us away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. And entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in long white garment, and they were frightened. And he said unto them, be not affrighted. Ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. Go your way and tell his disciples and Peter that they go before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him, as he said unto you. I read the 8th verse. And they went out quickly and fled from the sepulchre, for they were trembled and were amazed. Neither said they anything to anyone, for they were afraid. Now when Jesus was risen early the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had cast 7 devils. And she went and told them that had been with him. And they mourned and wept. Stop there. Amen. Resurrection Sunday, as we know. But I deem it necessary that we have a backdrop. Amen. Jesus, he was born from a virgin. Herod tried to kill him, but he couldn't handle him. You can't outlive him, and you can't live without him. He's the key to knowledge. He's the wellspring of wisdom. He's the foundation of faith. He's the doorway to deliverance. And he's the pathway to peace. He's the gateway to glory. He's the highway to happiness. This is Jesus. That and much more, Herod wanted to kill. But he could not have killed the promise. You know the story, guys. The long and short of it. You know. When he had told his disciples to go get the ass that was tied. When he was making his triumphant entry into Jerusalem. While he reached the descent at the mount called Olivet's. They were shouting Hosanna. And there were those who wanted to shut those down who was shouting Hosanna. But none that had an encounter with Jesus keeps quiet. Come on, somebody. Because they never had an encounter, that's why they didn't understand why they were shouting and crying Hosanna. When some of us have encounter with God, some of us cry tears. Some of us laugh, some run in the spirit because we have encountered God. Isaiah said that he's Emmanuel, God with us. Come and taste and see that the Lord is good. They never tasted at this man Jesus. When you tasted of this same Jesus, it brings joy and comfort to the soul. It gives peace. It heals our pain. This Jesus. This Jesus. Give peace. This Jesus here. Yeah. Yes, amen. Don't let anybody shut you up from shouting Jesus. And peace, holy peace. The rock star gonna call his name. Somebody's name is Jesus. Come talk about him today. So now they are captured. Our master in Gethsemane. And they dragged him. And they whipped him. Dragged him to the place called Calvary. And was hung the most disgraceful way. They stretched him wide and they hung him high. Put him in a parade for the world to see our Lord in this grace. Good God. He could have stood apart in his defense, but he saw my agony. Yes. He looked beyond my faults all the way from Calvary, and he saw my need. Yes. Someone had to die to reconcile us back to God, and there was one that was willing to die. To die in my stead. And he was willing to take my place. And somebody said, I should have been crucified. But Jesus took my place. He paid the price that I owe. I heard the sister sung, Jesus. Paid it all. Oh, to him I owe this morning. All he's asking for in exchange is our heart. He cried, I'm thirsty. And they gave him vinegar mixed with gall. When he tasted thereof, he could not choose. Thirsty. The nail in his hands. And his feet. They thought that it was a nail that kept him there. But it was not a nail that kept him there. It was love that kept him there. Talking about such love, the love of God. Such love that he brought down to man. Such love when we were condemned to die. He loved us so that he came and walked this sinful earth to redeem us from the cause of God. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. I come to tell you this morning that he had made a believe out of that man. Blessed are those who believe and don't sorrow. That's all you need to believe, and that's enough. Do we have a believer in the house that Jesus Christ is Son of the living God? And how he walks with me and he talks with me.
Hallelujah.
Even though one day, guys, we have a reflection way back on Calvary. Somewhere I said on a hill far away. So the old rugged cross, it is the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross for the dearest and best. Was a place where lost sinners was saved. In that old rugged cross, so despised by the world. I love that old cross. That old rugged cross. Can I identify with that cross? Love is a song that they were singing this morning. How they were nailed to the cross. They were nailed to the cross, and he carried my sins that were many within there. And I love that old cross for the dearest and best for the soul of us. Thought that it was over. Losing somebody here. Is there anybody here who have got a situation in your life that you are giving over? It's dead, dead, dead. It's not likely to think it's already dead. When they killed Jesus, they put soldiers on duty. They rolled a massive stone to make the grave secure. There was no Sabbath like this before, and there was none after. He laid to rest on that Sabbath day. But the Bible says, early Sunday morning, come to church. The Bible says that it began to dawn. Mary and the other Mary, they went down to the grave of Jesus. They brought some spices to anoint the body of our master. And they said within themselves, who will roll us away the stone? But when they went there, the stone was already rolled away. Can I say this to somebody? Ain't no stone can keep Jesus. Am I talking here? Did you know, if you want to talk about that stone, he is the rock. Rock of ages, pray for me. Let me hide myself in thee. He is the rock. And there, not even death could have hold him. Bible says on the third day he rose triumphantly. When the ladies went down to anoint our master, when they looked there, he was gone. They saw a young man and said that, if you know where they have taken my master, can you show me? Good God Almighty, the angels said that he's not here, he's risen. Come see the place where the Lord laid. When they went there the son, the linen cloth. Jesus was standing over away from the bed. He said to her, Mary, he said, Rabboni, me master. He was about to touch her, master. He says, touch me not, for I'm not yet ascended to my father. He was ascended to his father, and he came back and met his disciples in Galilee. Am I talking here, somebody? When I say this, somebody, while Jesus was crucified, two disciples, they were on their way to Emmaus, and while they were having conversation about our master, how he had been delivered into the hands of evil men, the chief priests, and how they crucified him. And Jesus drew nigh in the conversation. While they break the word of Almighty God, we got to learn to utilize the word of God. When we use this word, he'll draw nigh somebody. Am I talking to somebody? His word, your spirit, and your life. We can use the word. While Cleopas and the other disciples were on their way to Jerusalem, while they were reasoning, Jesus drew nigh and said, what manner of conversation is this? They said, art thou a stranger in Jerusalem that you have not known about how our master had been killed? And this day is now but the third day. But while Jesus reasoned with them, they didn't know that he was our master. Good God Almighty, when they went to break bread, Jesus revealed himself to them. I heard them say that did not our heart burn with us. Why they opened the scriptures? Can we open up the scriptures here to the people of God? The scripture says it is his will that he may prosper and be in good health. But this word that says with long life I will satisfy you and show you his salvation. His word said that he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide in the shadow of the Almighty. And we say the Lord is my refuge and fortress. My God, in whom I trust. Surely I don't want to be somebody. Oh, I don't have a lot of information, but surely I can tell you that I know this stuff. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I'm going to dwell in the house of the Lord. His word said, according to the psalmist David, hear my cry, O God. He understand your cry. He understand your pain. Attend to my prayer. When my heart's overwhelmed, I'm talking about the word here. When you use the word Jesus, Christ would have died. But even in death, he loved me. Samuel said, living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justifies. Free forever. One day he's coming over the glorious day. God, God Almighty. What a day of rejoicing that will be. Well, what Jesus we shall see when we look upon his face. How will be the one who saved me on his. What a day! There will be no tears coming from the eye. What a day when we get to that city. Good God Almighty. There'll be no more sickness in that city. There's going to be a tree of life. The fountain of living water is going to be here. We don't have to be thirsty again. Am I talking to a church? Close your eyes on the pearly white city. In the pearly white city. They killed him on Friday. But they didn't know that Sunday morning, the morning of resurrection, was fast approaching. He is the Lion, and he is the Lamb. He is God, and he is man. He is the King of Israel, and he is the nation's King. He is the King of righteousness, that's a moral King. He is the King of the ages, that's an eternal King. He is the King of heaven, that's a universal King. He is the King of glory, that's a celestial King. Put your hands together for the King of Kings.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
The coronet. But God, they call him king. Oh God, they call him king, all right, because he's a king. They're trying to imitate him, trying to camouflage, trying to make a mess of the thing, but they call him king. Even the devil have to declare him king. He made us to be prince and princesses. We are here and join here with Jesus. Am I talking here? Somebody indicate that we are royal priesthood. I'm acquainted with the name of Jesus. Because there is none other name given in heaven whereby men are to save. The name of Jesus. I've been acquainted with that name. Jesus.
My God. Hallelujah.
The mighty. Oh Lord,
yes,
they bow their knees and said, "Hail, King of the Jews."
Yes, my God.
They smote him in his face, says, "Prophesy, who hit you?" Good God Almighty. But he was only bearing my pain. He was only dealing with my anguish, what I should have dealt with. Good God Almighty.
All right, hallelujah.
And the third day. And the third day, boy. Can I say this to you? You're coming out.
Hallelujah.
It doesn't matter what the enemy puts on you. You're coming out with a shout. Am I talking somebody? Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The enemy robbed some of you, your joy. Oh yeah. And I stole some of your family members. But the resurrection day is fast approaching. You're going to laugh again, somebody. He's going to restore joy. He's going to restore double for your trouble. Am I talking here to a church that has expectance? That you're going to take back what the enemy has taken.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Glory to God. My God.
Here and join here with Jesus. Am I talking here to somebody in the kingdom? Royal priesthood. I'm acquainted with the name of Jesus. Because there is none other name given in heaven whereby men are to save. The name of Jesus. I've been acquainted with that name. Jesus.
My God. Hallelujah.
The mighty.
Yes,
oh Lord.
Yes,
they bow their knees and said, "Hail, King of the Jews."
Yes, my God.
They smote him in his face, says, "Prophesy, who hit you?" Good God Almighty. But he was only bearing my pain. He was only dealing with my anguish, what I should have dealt with. Good God Almighty.
All right, hallelujah.
And the third day. And the third day, boy. Can I say this to you? You're coming out.
Hallelujah.
It doesn't matter what the enemy puts on you. You're coming out with a shout. Am I talking to somebody? What's putting this thing? The Bible says there was a great earthquake. And the keepers of the great fell as they went. God was in operation here. None can stand in the way of Almighty God when God gets ready, man has to move. When God gets ready to work out his purpose, great men have to succumb and take shield and run from the power and the wrath and the fury of Almighty God. Dead men, lest they would have driven fear in these women. But I thank God for a praying woman. Read the scriptures. The Bible says, when the women were gone down to the grave, the disciples were left away weeping. And the woman brought it out and went down. To anoint and embalm the body of her son. There were no men there standing with them. That's why the Spirit of the Lord put out the guards. That the woman could go in there to see that he was risen to tell a resurrection message, that he was not dead, but he was alive, as he told you. Time is not spent, but I want to pray for some folks that is in need of a resurrection. Folks, upon this rock I build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. By you, my servant, I pray.
Anointing.